But first, bridge closed. Tonight, the Speaker of the House isn't the only one angered by the abrupt closure of the heavily traveled Cranston Bridge. New tonight, local businesses we talked to say they're already feeling the effects of the bridge closure after only 2 days.
And also new tonight, we tested out the detour in place to see just how convenient it is for drivers. Eyewitness News reporter Perry Russom joins us live on scene with the details.
The bridge is closed and police are guarding it from both sides. The House Speaker and Cranston's mayor are calling for an investigation, trying to figure out how the bridge was able to get this bad. And this closure isn't only affecting drivers, but businesses too. Elite Barbershop at the base of the Park Avenue Bridge is expecting to see a cut to their revenue with the bridge now closed.
When they told you that the bridge was going to close, what was your initial reaction?
They didn't tell us. They pulled up in Suburbans and put up barrels.
Kenny Elderkin is a barber here. We met with him on day two of the closure.
There's nothing you can do. I mean, I can't change what's happening.
This part right here is more of the hobbyist side.
Next door is APB Vapes. They've only been open for 2 months. Brandon Grand Mason says since the bridge is closed, he's lost at least $1,500 in sales.
Usually I have, you know, anywhere from 40 to 50 walk-in customers a day. I've had 6 today.
The bridge has about 15,000 crossings every day. With this new detour, we wanted to see how long it would take to go around the bridge, so we timed it. We did this after the rush hour traffic, and we hit every green light. It took us 4 minutes and 40 seconds. The DOT says before shutting it down, they got recommendations from 3 separate engineers and consulted with state police. They all agreed to close the bridge. They then sent the same engineering firm who inspected the bridge last year back to Park Avenue, and they agreed with the call, citing new wear and tear.
If they knew 9 months ago that it was going to require a high priority of corrective action, why wasn't any corrective action taken?
Back at the vape store, the future of this business is now resting on the crumbling bridge.
We might have to move our location if this bridge closing is going to take up to a year, like they said.
And the House Speaker's law offices are just down the road. We asked him if he thinks this is the governor and the DOT trying to force his hand on the road and bridge reconstruction project called Roadworks. He says this isn't going to force his hand. We're live in Cranston with the Mobile Newsroom. Perry Russom, Eyewitness News.